Hi everyone, in this video I wanna share you my experience how to install stairs on curved staircase. So here is I will show you how to pre-cut tread, how to pre-cut nosing, how to do measurements. I will show my way how I am doing this. First of all, I install risers and then I attach threads to the riser. Most of guys recommend do it first threads and then put riser on top. Why I am not doing this way? Because sometimes when if it's riser installed on top of the thread, if you step to the thread, sometimes you can see the gap between riser and thread. Let's go. So first of all, I'm using template or small piece of nosing to mark a line. This line I need to see how deep nosing settle on the stair. So I have one short line from the left and from the right. This is the point where I have to put jig, stair jig, and measure size of nosing. This is the main things. First of all, we measure nosing, pre-cut nosing, and then we measure tread. When we have nose, very easy calculate dimension of tread. If you saw my previous video how to do regular stairs, when I measure nosings with stair jig, I always make line with knife because it's very precise. But in this case, when I'm doing curved stairs, I using pencil. Why pencil? Because pencil give it to me from each side 16 of inch. Okay, 1/16. So why I need 1/16? Because there is a very small angles on the stairs, and with stair jig it's hard to take this dimension. But if you have from both sides 1/16, when you start settle this nosing, you will see this imperfection and you can mark with pencil and then pre-cut it perfectly. Okay, when I put nosing in, now I see the exactly dimension for thread from the left and right side. One more time I do marks and then I measure. So from this side it's 5 inch, and from another side, from right side, here is a 10 and 5/8. So now we know dimension from both sides, and then I'm using stair jig to measure install angles which I have to pre-cut. If you have stairs and floor installation in one project, always leave material long boards for stairs, so you need for riser and for treads, because sometimes when you finish floor you don't have enough material, long full boards for riser and treads. Okay, here is a very tricky measurements, because we have one side is 5 inch, another side 10 and 5/8. So this board 7 1/4, and I add to this board another small piece, because this back side of the thread should be with angle. So I am taping these two pieces together from front and the both side, because tape it's hold very properly these two pieces. This is really important because it's not sliding to the side. Now I have to add diagonal tape to make a straight line. So what I am doing, so if it's this side 5 inch, I measure like 5.5 inch, and this side I measure, for example, 11.25. Why a little bit more? Because I need tape is wider. So, and from that 2 points I put this tape. Okay, and then I have to measure one more this dimension from this side. I measure 5 inch, exactly 5 inch, and from another side 10 and 5/8. Now I'm gonna do two perpendicular lines from this point. Why I need it? Because I will attach to this line a stair jig. When I have this big line, you know what I like I did. It's easy to do it for me, because you know stair jig has some angles. You see? So when I sit up it, I make marks with pencil also, like I did for nosing. Why? I wanna tell you one more time. I do it because from one side 1/16, another side 1/16. So when I make mark with pencil, so together it's 1/8. So if wall has some, you know, little curve, which is I can take exactly with a stair jig, I can mark it later with pencil and pre-cut it more tight. Now I'm using beam level to make straight line between these 2 points. So after these marks I have 3 lines which I have to cut. This long line I have to cut with table saw, and 2 sides lines I will cut with miter saw. When you cut back side of thread on the table saw, don't put blade too high, and install blade with little angle from 2 to 5 degrees. Why? Because riser sometimes not perpendicular, and if you cut straight the thread, sometimes it's not attached tight to the riser. With angle it will be very precise. To make side cuts on this thread I'm using 10 inch DeWalt sliding miter saw with laser. It's my very favorite tools when I do stair installation, because I have few different saw, and 12 inches, 10 inches, 7.25 portable, but for stairs I'm using only this 10 inches because enough sliding dimension for installation any stairs. If you remember, I told you I made this thread a little bit bigger than needed, so it's approximately 1/8. You can see here is some curved gap, and I take the pencil and make the line, which is I will cut one more time. You see, and now this thread settled perfectly. So when we install nosing, it's ready to glue it and nail it. Here is, you see the stairs when it's done, looks very nice, customers like it. Now you have knowledge how to do it. If you like this video and my explanation, put thumbs up, share it, and if you have any question, ask me, I always answer you. See you on next video.